Finance Minister 1993 to 1997, perhaps one of the youngest, if not the youngest. You have seen the situation, what's happening in our country. There's huge debt. You've seen the economy slam. Now, this evening, the president has reversed all the cohesions that were put in place to ensure that at least Kenyans are comfortable, together with the global community, during the health pandemic, the coronavirus pandemic. He has reversed it. And from January, we are back to what it used to be. Do you think it's time that happens? The reason notwithstanding that we need to spur the economy.
Well, they have no option. They had no option. There's no alternative way out. And I'll tell you why. And indeed, if there's a job in town that you would dread
right
at
now,
this point in time,
yes,
is to be the Treasury Cabinet Secretary. It is a very, very awkward situation, a job at this point in time. But let's say why do they have no alternative? They have no alternative because the country cannot just generate sufficient revenues.
Okay.
Okay. Already, the economy was reeling backwards. You must remember that. So COVID merely accelerated the crisis. And one of the things that we have talked about, and I talked about, and many other Kenyans did talk about, is this thing that is the massive debt that is in our hands. All right? It is huge. And one of the things that the Treasury should have done is, as they increase the taxes, reverting to what it was before the COVID, there should have been some corresponding message on where they're cutting costs.
Which never works because we've had austerity for a long time.
They should have come out with also some very clear measures that they are going to suspend certain projects.
Major projects?
Yes.
Infrastructure projects?
If they have started. If it is contracted and it's ongoing, that's a different
matter. What if it's not financed by...
Those are the issues. Because this pressure that the Minister for Finance is facing is because there was a mismatch, a very serious mismatch, on the commitments that they made, that they wanted to do the following things within a very short time frame. Yet, the revenue stream could not match that.
Okay.
Now, they have no option because even the international community at this point in time does not have extra cash to throw around.
Yes.
COVID has hit the entire globe.
But not meeting your revenue projection, yearly revenue projection, is not a new thing to this country. I don't remember a single year that we met that. So there's a deficit, yes.
We used to meet it.
What even, was that?
Oh, even during the Kibaki time it was met. Even in the earlier times of the Uhuru Jubilee government, they were meeting it. But it's when they went overdrive, the commitments they were making, how many dams they wanted to put together, how many infrastructure capital projects they wanted to have within a very short time frame, how many stadia they wanted to put together. So all these were coming. It was a race against time.
Okay.
Because they had made so many promises.
Commitments that commitments. They couldn't match the resources.
Now, that is where it started going sour.
Okay. You have ambitions of being president in this country. Something happens in 2022, Musalia Mudavadi is the next president of the country. Are you worried about the kind of a country you'll inherit from President Uhuru Kenyatta in terms of the economy?
Of course I am.
How would you sort it out?
My friend, there are a lot of things that you'd have to do. First of all, let's get Kenyans to understand that this 8.4 trillion debt is a heavy burden. That debt must be rescheduled. It must be restructured.
We must renegotiate with the country.
We have to.
Okay.
All right? There are no two ways about it. Because that is the only way you will defer certain payments and certain installments to release sufficient cash into the economy to spur growth. We will have to deal more aggressively with the corruption and the wastage. We must shift our economy from a consumer-based economy to a productive economy.
Okay.
We are doing more in terms of consumption at this stage and very little in terms of wealth creation, job creation. So the policies must be focused to reorient our expenditure programs, our public expenditure programs, to what I'm talking about.
I just want to pick one of your solutions, renegotiating the debts we have. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. To some people, that's postponing the problem. I know it leaves a little with you in your hands for mm-hmm. the time being, mm-hmm. but it's postponing an imminent problem.
You see, why do you postpone it? It's renegotiating is getting some latitude so that the pressure is less. And I speak because I renegotiated Kenya's debt when I was Minister for Finance. I rescheduled and renegotiated okay. and restructured.
Does it go down in terms of...
You negotiate in many ways. There's okay. the interest rate that maybe has to be written off. The penalties must be written off and so forth, because there are issues that are going to arise.
Yes.
Now, once you do that, you start getting relief. And if you can then spur expansion, growth, positive growth in your economy, then you get more resources.
Okay.
Right? Right now, we are shrunk. Our economy has been shrinking. And that is why the pressure is mounting that even retrenchment may be revisited on us again.
Okay. The last time you held a job in this country was perhaps during retired President Kibaki's government.